إذا ما قالني ربي أما استحييت تعصيني وتخفي الذنب عن خلقي وبالعصيان تأتيني فكيف أجيب يا ويحي ومن ذا سوف يحميني أسلي النفس.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, my brothers and sisters. We're in the 12th day of this blessed month of Ramadan. And alhamdulillah, may Allah accept from our deeds. May Allah make us from those who actually benefit from the month of Ramadan. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as Ibn Abdullah ibn Abbas described them in the hadith that is collected by Bukhari Muslim, where he said, كَانَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ أَجْوَدَ النَّاسِ وَأَجْوَدَ مَا يَكُونَ فِي رَمَضَانِ حين يلقاه جبريل عليه السلام فيدارسه القرآن فلرسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أجود بالخير من ريح المرسلة. The Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم Abdullah ibn Abbas said about him, كان رسول الله, the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, أجود الناس, he was the most generous of people. وأجود ما يكون في رمضان, and he was more generous, especially in the month of Ramadan. حين يلقاه جبريل, when Jibreel would come and meet him every single night, فيدارسه القرآن, and they would review the Quran together. And that the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, he brought more blessings and خير than a wind that carries rain. So the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم was very honorable. He was very generous. Anas ibn Malik, in the hadith that is in Muslim, he described him where he said, ما سئل رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم على الإسلام شيئا إلا أعطاه. The Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم was never asked by a person wanting to enter Islam anything, but he would give this to the person. قال, he said, فجاء رجل فأعطاه غنما بين جبلين. A man came to him, and this was in the day of Hunain. A man came to him and he gave him a herd of sheep that were scattered between two mountains, countless amount of sheep. فرجع, and the man went back to his people and he said, فقال يا قومي, oh my people, أسلموا, accept Islam, فإن محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم يعطي عطاء من لا يخشى الفقر, وفي رواية من لا يخاف الفقر. The Messenger Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, he gives like a person who does not fear poverty. So the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم would give often, and he would give actually more in the month of Ramadan, because the month of Ramadan is a special month where the deeds are multiplied. So this concept of us giving sadaqah is something we may be neglectful in Ramadan. Sadaqah is also very highly encouraged in the month of Ramadan. And the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam, when he described sadaqah, he said, وَالصَّلَاةُ نُورٌ وَالصَّدَقَةُ بُرْهَانٌ وَالصَّبْرُ ضِيَاءٌ. He said, prayer is light, and giving charity is a burhan. It is the evidence for your faith. As Allah says, لَن تَنَالُوا الْبِرَّ حَتَّى تُنْفِقُوا مِمَّا تُحِبُّونَ وَمَا تُنْفِقُوا مِنْ شَيْءٍ فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ بِهِ عَلِيمٌ. Allah says, لَن تَنَالُوا الْبِرَّ, you will never achieve, you will never attain الْبِرَّ, which is to have righteousness, to be righteous. حَتَّى تُنْفِقُوا, until you give what you love. And whatever that you give of good, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is aware of it. وَمَا تَفْعَلُوا مِنْ خَيْرٍ فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ بِهِ عَلِيمٌ. I want us to understand these ayat, that whatever of good we do, you pray the extra rak'ah, you pray the sunnah prayers, you read more Quran today, you made more istighfar, know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is fully aware of it, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward you, inshallah, for your efforts. Allah also says, وَمَا تَفْعَلُوا مِنْ خَيْرٍ يَعْلَمُهُ اللَّهُ. Whatever of good you do, Allah is aware of it. وَتَزَوَّدُوا, we should increase ourselves in provision. فَإِنَّ خَيْرَ الزَّادِ التَّقْوَى. Indeed, the best provision we could increase ourselves is in taqwa, subhanAllah. Going back to taqwa, fasting and taqwa, giving and taqwa, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from the muttaqeen. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from those that they will see their good deeds in Yawm al-Qiyamah, and it will be said to them, إِنَّ هَذَا كَانَ لَكُمْ جَزَاءً وَكَانَ سَعْيُكُمْ مَشْكُورًا. This is your reward, and your efforts that you have done in this world, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has appreciated your good deed. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from those who are successful in Ramadan. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from those whose deeds will be accepted. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
إذا ما قالني ربي أما استحييت تعصيني وتخفي الذنب عن خلقي وبالعصيان تأتيني فكيف أجيب يا ويحي ومن ذا سوف يحميني أسلي النفس بالله.